Welcome to the transfer of liability video that is part of the car hire training series. In this video, we'll look at where TOL fits within the car hire data flow and look at types of TOLs and how to create TOL messages by reviewing car hire rules 4, 5, and 15 and provide some examples of these rules in the car accounting self-service application. On the data flow, TOL is directly related to the liability continuity system. It also communicates with the event repository and carrier systems. TOL is a transaction created to eliminate reclaims and minimize the need to communicate deprescribed car hire rates to other parties. TOL allows car hire to be electronically transferred to the responsible party. Using LCS and TOL messages, car hire liability should be properly calculated without the need for subsequent reclaim. Transfer of liability allows carriers to move car hire liability to the carrier that should be responsible per the car hire rules. The movement of liability is accomplished through the creation of electronic messages. TOL creates situations where the carrier paying car hire and the carrier in physical possession of the equipment are not the same. For example, when a carrier is acting as a switch carrier, the inbound line haul carrier has the car hire liability, and the switch carrier has physical possession of the car. A reclaim is a distinct financial transaction that allows a carrier to recover car hire that was not owed. A TOL is not a separate transaction. A TOL is an electronic message used in the determination of car hire liability. TOL eliminates the need for a reclaim. Car hire liability using LCS and TOL records can be assigned accurately when the initial car hire calculation is made. Three car hire rules allow the creation of TOL messages. Rule 4 allows the creation of TOL messages when empty cars are moved with revenue billing. Rule 5 allows the creation of TOL messages to move car hire to the line haul carrier's account when cars are handled in switching service. Rule 15 allows the creation of TOL messages when a carrier cannot accept delivery of cars. Carriers do not need to take any special action to get car hire relief under Rule 4. Railinc reviews all EDI 417 waybills for revenue empty sticks as defined in Car Hire Rule 4. When revenue empty sticks are identified, a TOL Train 28 message is created and sent to the car mark owner and the handling carrier. The transaction is also posted to the event repository. In this example, Railinc identifies empty sticks and creates a TOL Train 28 message that is sent to the car mark owner and the handling carrier on August 10th, as seen in event CH96 highlighted in pink. SRY has car hire relief until August 14th. In order to get car hire relief on cars handled in switching service, carriers must transmit the proper electronic messages to Railinc. A Train 08 or Train 10 message must be submitted by the switching carrier to Railinc within 25 days of the switch. The Train 2 manual defines the proper information and format for creating the message and contains specific examples of the dates and times to be used in the TOL process. As a general rule, the end of the TOL time is identified and a start time is calculated based on switch type. Railinc edits the messages for syntax and compliance with LCS interchange. The TOL cannot begin prior to assignment of liability to the switch carrier by LCS. The TOL cannot extend beyond the termination of the switch carrier's liability as defined by LCS. When a TOL is approved, Railinc sends a Train 28 message to the switch carrier, line haul carrier, and car mark owner. The transaction is also posted to the event repository. This message can be treated as an interchange when car hire liability is determined. If traced, equipment will be in the switching carrier's possession. There are two types of switching service: terminal switches and intermediate switches. First, we'll look at terminal switches. Two types of messages can be used to transmit terminal switching information to Railinc. Message type 80 accommodates situations in which the switch follows or precedes the line haul carrier move. The car is delivered to the switch carrier empty and returned loaded, or vice versa. Message type 85 accommodates situations in which the switch follows or precedes an intermediate switch. Car hire liability is transferred to the line haul carrier, not the intermediate switch carrier. The car is normally delivered to the terminal switch carrier empty and returned loaded, or vice versa. For terminal switches, the actual car hire up to a maximum of 120 hours of relief can be transferred. As always, in car accounting, carriers can negotiate a maximum number of hours that is higher or lower than the 120 hours specified in Car Hire Rule 5. The negotiated maximum must be registered with Railinc so that the programs know about the revised limit. The Train 2 manual has Form 80-104 that must be completed and filed with Railinc. Two message types are typically used to transmit information about intermediate switches. Message type 81 accommodates situations in which the switch carrier moves a car between two line haul carriers. Up to 24 hours can be transferred. A load-empty status of the car cannot change. Message type 84 accommodates situations in which an intermediate switch is made in conjunction with another switch. Up to 24 hours can be transferred. The load-empty status of the car cannot change. Car hire liability will be transferred to the line haul carrier, not another switch carrier. For intermediate switches, Car Hire Rule 5 allows the transfer of the actual car hire incurred up to a maximum of 24 hours. As with terminal switches, a higher or lower maximum can be negotiated bilaterally. The negotiated maximum must be registered with Railinc. This example in CAS illustrates the events typically seen when terminal switching is performed. The car was delivered loaded by CN to URR in terminal switching service on July 9th, as highlighted in green. URR reported the TOL to Railinc, event CH80, on July 9th, seen highlighted in purple. The transaction was approved and posted to the event repository. The TOL ended on July 11th after 53 hours when the car was delivered back to CN empty. URR incurred no car hire liability. Double-clicking on event CH80 opens the event details box. This shows the TOL information including start time, end time, switch road, car hire liable road, and switch type. This CAS example illustrates the events typically seen when intermediate switching is performed. The car was received from NS by ALS loaded. The appropriate train messages were sent to Railinc. Railinc created a train 28 for the same date and time of the interchange as displayed in the CH81 for August 26th. 24 hours of car hire was transferred to NS and no car hire was incurred by ALS. Double-clicking on event CH81 opens the event details box. This shows the TOL information including start time, end time, switch road, car hire liable road, and switch type. Car Hire Rule 15 is the third car hire rule that allows carriers to create TOL messages. Rule 15 covers the inability of a carrier to accept cars in interchange. A key assumption of Rule 15 and the associated TOL process is that railroad operating personnel are communicating about the status of the interchange. Without this communication, many electronic messages can be passed between two carriers to no effect. The holding carrier attempting to interchange sends a train message to Railinc and advises that the receiving carrier cannot accept a car or group of cars in interchange. The message should include names and phone numbers of the operating personnel involved in the discussion. Railinc sends a train message to the receiving carrier to advise that cars cannot be accepted in interchange and that the inbound carrier is requesting car hire relief per Rule 15. The receiving carrier must reply to the advice that relief has been requested. The receiving carrier can agree that it cannot accept the cars and accept the car hire liability or reject the claim that cars cannot be accepted. Class 1 carriers have 6 hours to respond, and other carriers have 12 hours to respond. When there is no response, the transaction is treated as though the carrier accepted liability. If the TOL is rejected by the receiving carrier, Railinc will create a message to advise the delivering carrier that there are no problems with the interchange. If the TOL is accepted by the receiving carrier, Railinc will create a Train 28 message to advise both carriers that liability has been transferred. When there is no response to the TOL request, Railinc treats the message as though the request was accepted. The TOL message must be used by both carriers in their liability calculations. No reclaim is required because LCS and TOL messages show the car in the proper car hire account. This illustration shows the data flow for an accepted Rule 15 TOL. First, a Train 08 message is sent to Railinc by the delivering carrier advising that interchange cannot be accomplished. Second, a Train 26 message is sent by Railinc to the carrier that allegedly cannot accept the car in interchange. The message advises that Rule 15 relief has been requested. Third, a Train 08 message is sent to Railinc by the carrier that cannot accept cars in interchange. The message advises that the carrier will accept car hire responsibility. And fourth, a Train 28 message is sent to the delivering carrier by Railinc advising that car hire liability has been transferred. This message is also sent to the carrier that cannot accept the cars and to the car mark owner. All parties must use the TOL message in their calculation of car hire liability. This chart illustrates the data flow when the TOL request is denied. First, a Train 08 message is sent to Railinc by the delivering carrier advising that interchange cannot be accomplished. Second, a Train 26 message is sent by Railinc to the carrier that allegedly cannot accept cars in interchange. The message advises that Rule 15 relief has been requested. Third, a Train 08 message is sent to Railinc by the carrier that allegedly cannot accept cars in interchange. The message advises that the carrier can accept cars in interchange. And fourth, a Train 29 message is sent to the delivering carrier by Railinc advising that the Rule 15 request has been denied. Car hire liability will not be transferred. This CAS example illustrates events typically seen in Rule 15 TOL situations. CN attempted to deliver cars to KCS. CN sent a Train 08 message to Railinc advising that KCS could not accept cars. Railinc forwarded the advice to KCS. KCS responded that it would accept car hire liability. The TOL was issued on July 11th at 1540. KCS car hire liability begins on July 11th at 1540. CN was able to accomplish the interchange on July 12th at 1607. And LCS created delivery with LCS code K to maintain continuity and end Rule 15 TOL on July 12th at 1606. Double-clicking ICHD shows the event details. That wraps up this overview on transfer of liability. Contact us for more information.